This is Luke Radowski in Minnesota with William A. Johnson, who's running for state rep in Iowa. Now, William actually did the impossible but very amazing task of actually joining together Occupy Wall Street and the Tea Party. How the hell did you manage that?
Okay. Well, just to clarify, it's Iowa State Senate that I'm running for. And the Occupy Wall Street and Occupy Tea Party, in Dubuque, we have something called Occupy Dubuque, and we have the Tea Party of Dubuque. What happened was there's a big issue that was affecting our city, I would say afflicting our city, as well as a lot of the other major cities in Iowa, which is the red light camera, or AIT, automated traffic enforcement. And what ended up happening when Occupy first got started, or nationally, and people started talking about it, I went to the very first Occupy meeting in Dubuque, and I was down on the corner there, and I met with the people that started the whole thing and started organizing it. Actually, a young lady, her name's Annie J. She actually works at an insurance company down there called Platinum. Anyway, long story short, started talking with them and I said, hey, listen, we may have different ideas of certain things and stuff, but I'm glad you guys are deciding to get someone involved and you're younger. I know you guys, you know, don't know anything about organization structure, and I'd like to help you figure out a little bit about what you're doing. And they were totally open with that, so I went to pretty much all their first meetings, first 2 weeks. We met almost every other day. And this was at the time while I'm still involved in the GOP and all this other stuff. And it wasn't, and I want to clarify something. For me, I saw it as there's a difference between compromise and cooperation. Compromise is when you have a principle that you give up for a benefit. Cooperation is when people that are in different groups cooperate, for the lack of a better term, together on a singular issue that they agree on. And when I talked to them about, well, initially, I'm telling you about my involvement in Occupy to explain how I was able to talk to them about this issue too. And I brought up, hey, red light camera issue, you know, this is a big deal. And the others are like, yeah, this is ridiculous. Because I pointed out, the very first time I went to Occupy in Dubuque, I actually wrote a paper that I read to them. That in my own words, I believe that the Occupy sprang from the same roots as the Tea Party. The Tea Party, modern movement, people could argue Rick Santelli, you know, made it more mainstream or whatnot, but it was because of the bailouts. They popped up and they were like, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, before they got co-opted by Gingrich and Palin and Beck and all of them and made it a Republican platform, it was very organic, it was very grassroots.
Yep.
Just like we see Occupy Wall Street at its stages right now, which the Democratic Party is kind of creeping in, but they're not in there yet. It kind of seems like the Democrats are kind of kiting away from Occupy Wall Street, which is interesting, but these two very organic groups, you know,
they started from the same source,
yeah,
which was the bailouts. Because now, on all disagreements, they came together, ironically, now not formally, but ironically, because they all realized, hey, wait a minute, the government taking billions of dollars from us and giving it to these mega banks and corporations somehow doesn't jive, right?
Yeah.
So the Tea Party started this way, Occupy started this way, and basically what they are is they're breakoffs from people that either were disaffected or have been involved and didn't like what was going on there.